Welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to be taking a look at MPC's giant, almost 22-inch long Eagle from Space 1999. This is the one with cargo pod and nuclear canisters. So it is that option there. Comes molded in tannish-colored plastic, gray, clear, with a full set of decals and some multimedia parts, full-function landing gear, sprung landing gear. It does have some options. They list right here some aluminum nozzles and landing struts. It does include the optional nuclear canisters. So let's start taking a look at everything. First up, of course, will be the manual as always. And the manual is quite large as well. Everything on here barely fits on the screen. I got a whole table full of parts here. But it folds out nicely. We don't have to go through every single step, but it is broken down so that even a mediocre model builder could get this absolute monster together. And there is a lot of styrene, over 300 parts. Now, I want to go back to the box. The inside box on this kit is actually your paint guide. And you can see that they're going to tell you all the colors to paint, full color paint guide, all over the outside of the inner box. So don't throw that away if you didn't notice it when you get yours. I'm going to need it. It tells you how to paint every single thing in the kit, using and where to put all your decals. So make sure you don't lose the inside of the box. Plus the back, of course, gives you some history about the TV show and the model itself. Speaking of multimedia parts, like I was, I left them in the plastic so that I didn't ruin them when I build mine. But these are the glazing, the glass for the windows. It's thick like it's supposed to be for outer space and completely clear. Then we've got some nice silver thread for the winch. And that functional landing gear. We've got our springs and smaller metal parts to hold all that together so that the landing gear will actually go boingo, boingo, boingo up and down when it has weight on it, just like the real thing. We've got two waterside decal sheets in this set. One is the standard decal sheet that comes with the kit. You can see all those super tiny markings. Remember, just follow the directions on the outside of the box in full color. Those will come up for you real easy. Then we've got the nuclear waste canister decals and some other call-outs and mini decals. You can see those all there. All nice register in great condition. Shouldn't be a problem applying those. Never really had a problem with round two decals. Now we've got a lot of duplicate trees here. So I'm not going to show you every single sprue. I'm going to show you one example out of each one, and then you can go from there. So we've got this part here that's just loose in the kit. One of the ends there, nice panel lines on there. You'll get two of these trees for your cargo. Look at the detail inside there. You're going to get two, just like so. Once you love the sound of plastic bouncing around that new styrene, you're going to get two of the tubular frame here. Two of those trees. Moving on to more of the cargo pod areas. We got this giant slug of styrene here, this deck here. Great detail. It's not warped. It's not fuzzy. We'll give the camera a second to catch up because that is a lot of plastic to try to focus on. You can see the detail inside there. Over here on this tree, more tubular parts of the frame. The fuselage of the aircraft. And then this giant piece here. It's so cool to look at all this stuff, all the different tubing and ways they've set this up. Now this tree here has more cross bracing and tubing, and then it also has our pilot figures on it. You'll get two of these trees. And those look wonderful. We'll get that out of the way so you can get a better look at just the singles. Two of those. Up next back here, we've got more of our cockpit nose of the aircraft. And you'll get two of these trees. We can catch the detail on there. Sweet panel detail. Fans and exhausts. That's nice. You get exactly two of those. Let's move over to some more plastic. We got that. And that. Like I said, over 300 parts. That's an enormous kit. You're going to go through a lot of glue. You'll get two of these trees, and you can see by the size of my hand, none of this stuff is teeny. Two of those, and two of these. All looks great. I haven't noticed any big issues with flash or short shots. No problems at all. Two of those trees there. We've got another set of two trees. These are your waste containers. Everything looks nice. No problems. I like that detail molded in like so. And you can see the nice smooth, just ready for painting if you want to paint it. Two of those trees. Let's move on to the last white tree. You're going to get four of those, as you can see. That's going to deal with your landing gear, engines, the flash is where it belongs in the sprue, not on the parts. Even all the little pins on all the little tubing is in great shape. Four of those trees. And finally, after everything, we've got our gray tree. Four of these for the engines. Some of these parts of which can be replaced with the optional aluminum sets. Got the pads for the landing gear, that sprung landing gear. So that's it. That is all the plastic in this kit. 300 plus parts. It's enormous. 22 inches long, almost 2 feet. MPC's Space 1999 Eagle with the optional nuclear waste canisters. The winch to lower it up and down is all in there. The thread, everything to make it just like it appears on the box top, with a full paint and detail guide all around the inner box. I'm going to post a link in the description of where you can get yours, where I got mine from. Thanks for watching the workshop. I'll see you at the next review.